sente kubulungi wala bikasakula
bango na 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 agamba tontwala byanagalali stories ange siza kusindikibwa
Neo gwenagalali
Chitontome
Chitontome
Because music is poetry, man.
Oh, please.
Tontwala byanagalali.
Good morning, Kampala. Good morning, Uganda. Yes, just like that, we are getting this show on the road. Willis, Tinafis, Derek, and of course, the one and only DJ Sheila on the ones and twos. We'll be taking you up to 8 a.m. You definitely have to hold on too tight because this time around, jam-packed.
Oh, is it jam-packed? Yeah. People, it's a Friday and I decided to borrow Willis's suspenders. I honestly feel like they look better on me than they do him.
Ah, but don't you feel the freedom of putting on suspenders?
No, it feels good not to wear a belt. It feels good not to wear a belt because my pants are not dropping. Do not. But guess what, people? In the true tradition of being Tina Fierce One, I'm going to do what I do every Friday. You ready?
Huh.
You ready?
Yes.
It's a Friday! God!
Have you finished?
Yes, I
have. Yeah. Okay.
I don't guess if you're waking up with us, you know what time it is. Join us and the conversation. You can always go on social media. That's at TinaFierce1, at Willis Daily, at Aina Derek, and at Sheila, the one and only our DJ. And we are going to. What are we doing today?
Simon, just wake up to watch this show because there's two women. It's okay.
It's all right.
I said women, wake up to watch this show just
because
there's
two men.
No, because there's me.
Because there's me. They've disregarded your manhood. They have disregarded your manhood.
And some of them are, by the way, some of them are in Jiruhura. They wake up to watch me.
It's okay.
Starting
with next week, Willis is not going to be on the show. It's official. Now it's up to you whether you want to watch me or not. Make a choice. Make a choice.
Can I have one option?
Is it called a choice? A choice.
A choice. Yeah, man. Choice.
Is that your one?
We had a gate man who would say, "Ine nafuza na chanis."
Chanis, no, but seriously, chanis is how people call it in like local terms.
Chanis, it's called.
There are people who call it chanis.
But anyway,
ask Enyamu Choro. If you give them and tell them Zinuk, they'll be like Chinese.
Tell them what? Zinuk.
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 Mbuchino chichi.
And they will tell you.
But you see, I would understand
and
that.
And then they call the caps a sapeo.
I would understand because when you go to the villages, there's the town center. Agumata to the town center, you go to the village, then you get inside. Where there is now a kabara and some menvu for sale, or was it a Chinese?
Chinese.
So I would understand
the small menvu, what is it called? Kabalagala.
Obwanda,
what's your problem?
No, Obwanda and pancakes, what is your problem?
Pancakes in your
Kabalagala,
Kabalagala, the small banana.
Njakuku, what we call national television.
Yeah, one more agamato kaga
Kabalagala.
What is
it?
No, it's funny.
No.
Like, are we serious?
No.
Guys, the small bananas.
The small bananas are called Kabalagala.
They're called Kabalagala.
Yes.
They're called Kabalagala.
This is different. This is Mufumba no Mufumba ne Bamulia.
Are we seriously having an argument about Kabalagala?
No. Guys, wait. We need to dial this back. The small bananas.
The small ones.
Are called ndizi.
Nedda. They are called kabalagala.
Ndizi, kati ulira. Ndizi, bama yino mufu mbanga amatoke ne bamulya mu katogo.
Atendizi.
Atendizi.
Kakati kabalagala. Kakati kabalagala.
Oyo. Mulala, waliwo chivuvu, ndizi, amatoke, bogoya.
Atena Sheila has killed this. Kabalagala is pancake.
Yeah.
How do you call pancakes in Luganda?
Obanda.
In Luganda,
wa kabalagala chitufu.
Yes.
Na iwa liya amevu, waga kula kabalagala, waga ita kabalagala.
Ndizi.
Amevu
ga kabalagala.
Ndizi, by the way, she wamulia na amevu. Ndizi wa mufumba
amevu. I'm sorry, I'm getting hit. Yeah.
But I think
I'm telling you, Obubanda is what they call pancakes.
Oh, it's to Wali Amatoke. Wali Amatoke.
Kabalagala.
So, all of you are the right side for us to
say. So, now.
fun and entertainment. Oh, they're yeah. getting the shout outs on to your faces. Yes, the shout outs are going to the senior four backest. Chief Chaya, so anyone who made it, congratulations. If you didn't make it, it is okay. I mean,
it's all right.
There are some artists who did not make it.
But all artists.
They are still giving us hit after hit.
And they are rich.
Yeah. But for those of you who did set your goals, set your targets as far as the aggregates are concerned, and you made it, congratulations to you. We'll see you in the advanced level of life. That's why we call it. Nothing else. Shout outs to you, man. Well done.
Yeah, those guys went back to ESFO because they want to stand as MPs in 2021.
What went? Lord. Anyway, I'm sending my shout outs to the people of Karamoja. I don't even know how I'm supposed to send these shout outs. I don't know if I should shout out to the people in Karamoja or shout out to the government for the people of Karamoja.
First, tell us the story, then you decide.
Now, I'll tell you. According to the new vision, that is of 2 days ago, apparently people in Karamoja have abandoned using condoms. The reason. The reason they are giving, like, for to be called a Katulie I'm giving my metaphors, leave me alone. I wanted you to see the different variation. Mm-hmm. So on that note, Benai, I'm shouting out actually to government. Muta searching, you know, they need XXL, they need magnums, they need the ones with the golden wrappers. I'm just saying.
The
we can't have no, we cannot have grown men giving an excuse for not wearing protection. They are small. It's embarrassing. Decide.
Are they small as in diameter or what length?
One in every way possible.
Whether length, diameter.
Tezibatu, kabana government.
Shout out to Andy Chusuza and shout out to people from Karamoja.
Yeah. Hi, daddy.
Coursework, homework, holiday work.
Package.
What?
You're not reading
that.
Miscellaneous.
Yeah, so that's my shout out. You know, it's a sad thing, but it's laughable. I won't. Do you know anyone from Karamoja?
Yeah.
I don't have any Karamojong friend. I want to sit down and have a conversation.
I hook you up. I got you.
No, it's not that kind of hookup.
No, but in that regard,
you know, it's that kind of hookup.
No,
it is that kind of
hookup. No, it ain't.
All right, because we're on air.
No, it's not about being on air.
In that regard,
shut up. That's your mouth. Shut up, Willis. You're still using the ones that they put in bathrooms at restrooms. The smallest.
There are some people that cannot come from Karamoja. There is no a short person in Karamoja.
On that note, On that note, I'd like to shout out to people in Kamarole, Fort Poto. Apparently, 60 boxes of medicine have gone missing.
Now,
and, how these guys are transporting the medicine from health care centers is they are buying coffins and putting the medicine in there and transporting the medicine to wherever they want transported. So packs of Coartem are missing, and apparently a unit from State House has gone into investigation, and they are finding one of the people who is responsible was actually said 3 cases dropped because there was no witness. And I'm wondering, there's no medicine in hospital. The guy is there, and what is there to witness?
But
the next time you see a coffin in Fort Portal,
please check. It may be your Coartem, it may be your anti-malarious. But you see, cutting number, what did you tell that woman?
There's a team from State House that went to down
investigate.
But I never thought Wadoro were that sly.
They
are cool people.
How do you put medicine in a coffin? As in, think about the two things.
How much is a coffin?
Forget that. Medicine is supposed to heal. A coffin is supposed to take a dead person.
No, they're trying to heal the death. And I'm
trying to heal the death.
This day, and of course, in different parts of the country, for you to avoid starting bubbles, you need to know what kind of temperatures to expect up next. I know what not this way.
All right, there you have it for some of the temperatures to expect in different parts of the country. But moving away from that, once you get straight into last night online, we do have a Facebook post.
We are trying to conserve wildlife. Never know how I'm going to go. Any good business, yeah,
you're going to go. You
don't have, when you've eaten food, I'm just putting that first gallop. It first gets stuck here.
Wait, so like, how do you put food and gallop?
How do you put food?
How did you eat it?
Together, you have no tutorial.
But you say that and you gallop food.
How do you food?
How do you gallop food?
Let's get into last night online. We do have a post coming in from, of course, the immigration now. Uganda, right there. They do have a poster on their Facebook page. They say that Uganda immigration, dear visa applicants, do not fall victim to scammers. The only authentic visa application portal to Uganda is www.visas.migration.ug.org. Now, of course, you can get more details on that post, but what they are trying to say is that there's only one way for anyone to get visa to any particular country that you would be interested in traveling. Now, of course, there are some people you will actually talk to and they will tell you, I can get you this visa at a few, you know, Ugandan shillings. But they give you the website right there. You could just write it down, and in case you need a visa, you could, you know, just make it simple and get over to their website. It costs only $50.
I wish they could do the same for work permits. There are scammers in that work permit office. I've been trying to get a work permit for a friend of mine, and it is impossible. I think they need to do the same thing for...
You know, when you go to Facebook and say, probably visit Beijing, Beijing is one of those free visa countries, at least for Uganda. But you'll find people on the streets here telling our friends... Visa. Later, Dora Vitano, visa here, Beijing. You understand? And people, because they are not informed, they find themselves being scammed. So that's this immigration is trying to help foreigners who are trying to come to Uganda. That for you to come and be a tourist in Uganda, it's $50 only, and there is a specific website for it.
For it, yeah.
So if you're trying to go abroad as a Ugandan, please do some research. Google about these countries. Find out about the official website in embassies. The problem is that we feel like it's a crime to go abroad. So when you're there saying, I want to go to Australia, kakati, we're not going to go embassy, we're going to go to ma. But it's easier to just go to the embassy and be like, I want to visit this country.
Yes.
What's the process? And they give you the process. If you meet them, you go. If you don't, you stay. Simple.
And people at embassies are like customer care, you know, helpliners.
Helpliners?
Customer care. What did you say? I thought it died. It didn't die.
It didn't die. It's a baby. This guy is about to kill it. Liners.
At embassies, what? Customer care help liners.
Help liners.
Are you Google?
No, customer care help liners.
Let's get into the first digest for this particular morning. Of course, being a Friday, the Kampala Sun is out. We definitely have to keep you acquainted with what is happening in the land of gossip and entertainment. But beginning it off with the new vision that is going for only 2,000 Ugandan shillings. If I could look at the headline, you're talking about four schools in your district. Now, they're bringing you some pictures of the candidates that did perform well. These are some of the people I'm sending the shout-outs to. So you get a copy of the new vision and get to catch up with the top 1,000 candidates as well, looking into national ranking. That is, of course, best 1,400 schools. They do bring you a full list on page 22, 23, 46, and 47. Best schools per district as well, regarding the percentage, the average performance as well, right there. So they're giving the most detailed information regarding the senior poll result. President Museveni does meet the new Orthodox Bishop of Gulu. Get to catch up with that, as well as a couple of other interesting stories. Not forgetting some regional news. Harvest Money, it's around the corner. And of course, understanding that on the 15th, the Harvest Money Expo is going to be going down at Namboli. You definitely have to keep that 10,000 Ugandan shillings. And then some vision sport for you. Not forgetting the beat, where they bring you some enticing, entertaining news. And then, of course, the local and international sports.
And let's quick look at your Kampala Sun. The Kampala Sun has brought the heat. They definitely have. You can't read this alone. They are saying, Judith Babidia is my mom, says abandoned girl. And then you know what Judith Babidia says back? Let her report me to police. Simple. And about you people, Fatboy still exists.
Fatboy, he's still there.
A bit shocked. He's been on. He has been on the airwaves for 40 years.
By the way, and Fatboy has lost weight. Fatboy's picture and put it in a museum.
Yeah.
That guy started radio in Uganda.
No, he started it when he was still in China. When they opened Sanyu, he was the first person on the air.
We need to treasure this guy.
He's a national treasure.
And he sounds the same. He tells the same jokes.
I know, right?
The same.
He still has the same raw sense of humor.
And man, people seem to like the same things.
I mean, to each his own.
He has grown with his own.
Anyway, they are saying Fatboy loses weight for a chick. I think finally it's going to happen. Celeb death match. Enanga escorts Kaima out of office. There's that and a lot much more.
We'll treasure fired over what?
Kickbacks.
That is some spots for you right there.
Okay. That's in the spots.
Mubuke ndeswa ichasizo kunyumiriri ku page ya mukaga rutaya ise azako haya. Baganche muimbi Geoffrey rutaya yomu kubaise ibuzo vya senior 4 ebi afurumizi dwe guro ya itide mudara ya kuna division 4 ya somie mubiaba kuru. Division 4 wey.
Division
I am waiting for the two of you to first actually give this man a hand.
Yes. He's actually
No, you don't understand.
It's actually evidence that you don't need to go to school when you're 16. You can go and do your things
when you're 52.
Lutaya Geoffrey Lutaya the one
who Lutaya sana me no yekenyini. I'm just saying
Soko in the but what is the other chick's name?
Oh yo.
Wait, Geoffrey, the one who was in Eagles production. So when you go, Geoffrey, Daya.
That one. Yeah, it's in the Mudari.
Four. No, I'm just saying, before we can even say anything more, man, it's a big up to him, you know?
Musomesaba
now.
I believe that it's evidence that otherwise, you're there and you realize you need to get more info.
Kenzo Tata.
But
Kenzo
has dreams of building up schools.
But
John Brack.
He finds your son, and your son has dodged classes. You
think this is a conversation.
He's going to tell your son to go back to class.
No, can we have a conversation?
Hey, Kati, I'm the son.
You're the son.
You're
the
educator.
So who's
educator?
Hello, younger man.
Yes, teacher.
What are you doing here?
I'm sorry.
So come take over here, kana kamugambe. Deyo mukira.
Educator. Mama, why the one was asking me which class I'm on?
I'm the one. I'm
the one. Because I'm a 2007. Alright, welcome back from that short break. And of course, you're still watching Aben Today Radio on Aben Television. How about you get in touch on our social media pages? Facebook, it is Aben Television, and of course for Twitter, it is at Aben TV Uganda. You can tag me at Aina Dash as well as TPS1, not forgetting Willis Daily, DJ Sheila as well. And if you're interested in any DJing skills, you need some a PA system, you can as well as get to Facebook and look for Gong DJs located in Kisasi, and they'll definitely hook you up with some amazing systems and of course some amazing DJs that will crack you up and give you a fun evening. Moving away from that, we're getting into Tea at 7 this particular morning. Now, this one is an interesting one. We didn't see it coming. Now, apparently, there's a story in the news that Kadaga attained a certain big role in parliament after she had consulted the witch doctor. That is roughly the story. Now, the story behind it is that a traditional healer has actually sued Speaker Rebecca Kadaga, who has failed to pay him 200 million Ugandan shillings. Now, here is the story behind it. So this lady wanted to attain political influence. Mbu, that's what I'm
saying.
She wanted to attain this political influence, be driven in convoys like the president. So now they're in the warm south. So in getting there, the guy was like, it's okay. Apparently, the guy even remembers the dates. It was on 1st September and 2nd. He says it took him 2 days to actually come up with whatever concoction he did come up with. And then on the 3rd of September, I think that was around the year 1990, the president calls in Rebecca Kadaga as a minister. So the story goes on, you know, growing and growing. And this guy comes out to say that so far, he has only received 1 million Ugandan shillings out of the 200 million. That Rebecca Kadaga was supposed to give this young man. Now,
Tina WhatsApp.
Bunyoro, muinaba logo.
Let Veruliana
abantu. Mutia na yemu soko mulabye. Katika
Rebecca Kadaga.
Pele tuloga loga biro simba.
Mulogera biri nofuna speaker.
2 days.
I said the person Rebecca, right honorable Rebecca Kadaga is third, I think, in position of power.
Yeah.
The president, vice president, speaker of parliament.
Yes.
Yeah. So, I mean,
but it's a
Bafuka Kappa. Kiriyari, abuzako levonga bini.
Ata ninge nchwe kapa. But here's the thing. You'll catch on train your
question. So don't worry, abali wabuwa speaker. They jan enchu
meow. Did it story to us? You have never heard of the story.
Pussycats.
Hey.
Okay.
Apparently.
But the thing though, has the speaker come out to say anything? Nothing.
They tried to get in touch with her
but
yesterday.
But then the thing, though,
she was chairing meetings in the parliament,
so we haven't had
any story from her.
Is this a whistleblower? No. Did we see this coming? Hell no. We've seen her go visit shrines. I mean,
Yes, on national television.
Just like you've seen the what was his name? Mahogany.
Yeah.
But you see, Kati. As a Ugandan, this makes me question. So you didn't get your job on merit. You got it.
What do you mean?
Through ancestral spirits.
When I go to church and pray and get a job, do you say I didn't get it?
It wasn't on merit. God yakusulid them. We may be trying to make fun of this. She doesn't know that you have a church in Ebidako. That is her God. And if her God is working like that, just come and pay the money.
The constitution of Uganda gives you a right.
Right of worship.
Of worship. Mm-hmm. You understand? That's you can true. Worship your judges, you can worship.
Pastor, yeyongo, limutu kilibu, njagalo sindike fire.
Ewani. For what?
Ewani. Bana musabe.
Kati gobele yoki mujizasi, yoro ato sindikila
kila fire. Musabe, tell them ze musabe.
Nika ala weleo.
I didn't tell them.
You just said let pastors send fire.
Let them send fire. Have I directed it to anyone?
To who? Why?
What if I'm telling them to send it to me?
Sure.
Did they specify?
I believe.
But guys, what if there is a twist in this story?
Which twist?
What if this guy is just looking for cheap popularity?
Bring it back.
You've heard where I'm coming from.
What I'm saying is, I thought the twist you're talking about is the 2 days that he spent working on her.
What was he working
exactly.
on?
Exactly. That's where.
Is she like a car? Is she like, what was going on? Were they open space? Were they dressed? Were they naked? What was going on for 2 days?
My problem is us being so sure that this did actually happen.
We are speaking in the terms of
Ntino. We are speaking in the terms of there's actually what a guy who is suing. So
and he's suing.
Whether it's true or not, that is for the court to decide.
But
for us, we can talk about it. It's okay.
But first, wait. Nowadays, which doctors are going to the courts of law? Tebacha sindika mayembe, tebacha akumenya amenyo mulima. You know how they say, wakanyo kulete ntaya whitey.
Amayembe no longer brings money. Apparently, this guy wants his money. 200 million Ugandan shillings.
The Mayembe might bring the money, but the problem is, you might have shifted and went to a better guy.
Why?
Let me try courts of law.
But this is interesting.
You go to a witch doctor. and enter into an agreement. That's a binding contract.
It is a binding contract.
I'm going to send you my demons. Okay, my ghosts. Yep. They come and push you higher in society. You pay me this kind of money. That's a contract. It's valid before in a court of law.
Yes.
And you know,
and given the fact that you are even in that position of power, that took you and him in the first place.
This agreement.
No,
it's a verbal. It is a verbal. It is a verbal. It's also legal.
It's an oral. But there's
someone will challenge you and say that you don't have evidence.
You can't prove it.
Who doesn't have evidence?
You can't prove.
Are you trying to dare a witch doctor to prove things?
Yes.
What? They go and test your DNA and find out, hey, this man has your kafiri, how? Unless
me, I do not.
No. I don't want to fall for that. Me, I believe.
Which doctors ask for bodily things? They ask for your hair, they ask for your how teeth, you for know? Your whatever. That's what the Tuvi Mani, Gwetola, they ask for these things.
Why didn't Kadaga, though, go to Mama Fina?
She wasn't the president of the healers then. She was also in rehearsals. There were other people.
She was also undergoing such a
coursework. But this is a touchy subject for me, though.
In those years, the 1990s, witchcraft in Uganda was really huge.
It was. Still is.
And including mostly, actually, politicians. Up to now, I think, they consult witch doctors and the gods to give them blessings to make it in their careers. And you see, the witch doctors, even in the Bible, Bagamba, God tells you to avoid magicians and whatnot. Not that they don't work. They actually do. But their thing is they short-circuit the system. Sort of give you a short... They take you to your destination really fast. That's why even God advises against them. You understand? He tells you to avoid them because they short circuit it. That's logically. So when they short circuit it, the effects of whatever comes
you should have
to
gone
you,
through.
God tells you to avoid them because of that. So if God is telling you to avoid them, to avoid witch doctors, and you don't avoid them, there are some of the things that you know.
But is it, you see, for me, someone was asking like, but morally, Tina, that's wrong, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, you know what? To each his own, you know? I mean, the spiritual realm, we all believe in what we want to believe in.
What do you
mean
what is
wrong? But the thing for me,
what do you mean? I mean, if you're born again, you know, and you're praying, you're praying to God and say, God, you did it for Musa. Musa died.
But what?
Clearly, it's a ghost. Aren't you the same person? Aren't you on the same level as someone who's saying Mukasa?
Because they're all dying. They're
had his own miracles that he did.
No,
Mukasa was associated with the gods. Musa is associated with
the gods. We are reading miracles. It's just that we are reading from different books.
Thank you.
But they're the same thing. You watched Ed Griffin's...
I did. And I said, put the book down.
Yeah.
It will mess you up. And I still believe that. Because that's what I was saying. To each his own. If she felt that was what she wanted to do, then good for her. She got the position of power. But my thing, though, is... On a witch doctor, genda kufuna ba customer. Do you know how many politicians before he even enters the courtroom, parliamentarians are going to first be on that one? I see them like rice or white
right
on
now,
rice.
This guy and also Bobby Wine must be getting very many calls from politicians.
Of course.
Politicians.
Umusa woyani.
Tweet it.
People like Bobby Wine.
Met Jesse J. Bobby Wine was in Jamaica. Bobby Wine was on
Baby Musa Wawak.
So everyone
Musa Wawak.
Of course Kadaga is huge. And of course, if I'm a politician and I hear such a story, I'd look for the guy and be like, so wait, I can help you get the 100 million.
But no, this guy wants his 200 million. Apparently, they were supposed to build him a house. What 100 million?
I have to believe. What did they do in those 2 days?
They were supposed to give him cows, fresh and cows.
Three,
they were supposed to give him land.
What?
Worth 45 million Ugandan.
And then 200 million also.
No, when you get all that we're supposed to give, it totals to 200 million Ugandan shillings.
But then also...
What did he do in those 2 days?
But then also, this guy is also lying. This guy is also lying and they take us for granted. One is that when you go to a witch doctor, they don't ask money from you for them. Yeah, that's what they usually say. So you go to the hospital, you go to the
hospital.
Which
doctors?
Yamusaba cash. Let me tell you, a witch doctor will ask you things for gods, for spirits. A witch doctor will ask you for sacrifices. They won't ask you for assets.
All these were asked.
So how does
and
the judge
servant? Let me tell you this. Hypothetically speaking, I think judge Neba tunulira savanti wapo. Neba muyiiza. Neba gamba. Mtabani. Kubiyo nabiyo tukoledde. Nafe katubeyo cha tukukoleda. Ati nafe tubele
hapi. Ono mkaza hapi.
Akuzimbile nyumba. Akugulile motoka. Lindako. Kubanga. Bati manyi. Ono mtabani ya kendo kubale tiranga bakira ya. Chabaneni.
But don't you see those things in churches? Whereby people contribute money to buy a house for the pastor.
That's the difference.
Ah, me what killed me is when they contribute money to buy to get a wife for the pastor.
That's the difference. In the witchcraft, witch doctors
association.
Judges don't ask for things like that because they are not going to use them. The formula is that tell the Mulwadi to judge Ayagari Intebweti so that the Mulwadi feels like she or he is sacrificing something.
But let me ask you something.
Buy me land, Kakati, hold on a minute. Rebecca Kataga, Right Honorable, at that time was not Speaker of Parliament. She didn't have the money and assets that she has now. So what
was against that? Interest. They saw the potential.
And if you're there and you go to shrines and whatever, a witch doctor is not going to ask you more than they think you can afford.
Listen,
when you go
to can't afford. Kakati, how do you explain? And they ask them, Njagalo gendo ndetere a camel that has no hump. I want you to bring for me a goat. Njagalo fune kaliaka tala kwa musota.
Aren't you worried that chaba tegeza anti impasente nge nembi gule. So si impasente.
Kati zezo sente.
Zezo
sente. Zezo
sente. No, Musa Omuganda is not going to tell you to build them a house.
Mbana kambi ali Muganda. Ugwana gambi yali muganda.
Yali muteso. Sawo mteso.
Wachofi yali munyolo.
There is no shrine in
Barara. Baba fesima sawo.
Hey, bachi.
Febalo gabulozi.
What if the guy was a mutoro?
Have you ever heard the judge is a munyankole?
By the way, I've never heard him.
Judges are Baganda, Basoga,
but this guy is not a judge.
No, they consult judges.
The judges, they consult.
Wait, Abanyangwale the Mwine Jaja?
Impossible. Have you ever had a shrine in Barara?
Wait, the shrines might be there, but do you have
it? What if they have the carcass?
The what?
What a carcass?
Kaka is grandma.
When you look at it logically, I think that this guy is just trying to
get a story out there.
Yeah, get a story, and also he might be a witch doctor, but looking for a name for himself.
And he done got it.
Yeah, I think that the Right Honorable might have visited some shrines in the past because she still does. You understand? So I believe she might have visited. Now, to say she visited a guy, and the guy
and the
asked
inception.
For 200 million for land, for a house.
What if it has grown in interest? Originally, what if when she went there, the original price was like 10 million?
Yeah, because apparently she cashed 1 million.
Okay. So she first cashed.
Guy even remembers the date.
Nkola ako kati. They did that.
You get what I'm saying? Mm. And then he expected to get his money because it definitely worked. She skyrocketed out of everything. And then...
Ministry of Posts.
I know. She just stopped picking up his calls. I don't know if which doctors use calls or they send via their Bluetooth.
They call you through Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi. But seriously. Mm. And then, over the years, he's seen her success grow and grow. He's like, Zakazi, the 10 million.
Now it is
20 years ago.
Now it's 200.
Let us do the mathematics.
Plus
the mathematics.
I was getting business because I thought you would advertise me,
but you didn't. You don't even send your favorite.
Now that you are going to court, imagine the judge says, "You know what, Kadaga, you have been proven guilty."
But also, that will happen.
Oh, that will be a fun.
That will happen.
No, I will look for that.
Yeah. Wait, that will happen if the judge also believes in that kind of thing.
But of course, you know the judge will be talking to on the sidebar. The judge will be like,
Abuza witness, suspect.
Suspect, yeah.
Plaintiff. Plaintiff.
Mm.
Is it true that you did it? Yes, if it is true, make me chief justice. When you make me chief justice, she's guilty.
Okay. Thank you.
But I think, though, on a serious note, though, that people have been robbed through lied to. On the other hand, as well, some of these things have actually worked and affected people's lives, both positively and negatively. We need to agree to that. But you find that these families where you go to and they tell you, then there are these stories of Boyo Guy. That's the truth. Boyo Guy, I need to say, then there are the stories of this guy doesn't sleep at night. Mbusimanya, then they come to our world of I have insomnia.
Oh, yeah, nowadays
my
it's
friend,
insomnia.
You are the one
be
who
careful.
All the demons of your family.
Careful. If you're insomnia,
ready on Urban Television. DJ Shil, are you ready to give us some music as we get into a break? And when we do get back, we'll jump straight into the world of sports.